Shanna Sykes is a rural health and nutrition agent with Clemson Extension, and she's based in Anderson County, where she has several programs going on. So let's talk about that, and what's the overall goal of your team?
So our team is to improve rural health and nutrition, just like our title says. So, you know, areas that really just bringing in whatever we can to the community and helping them. We have grants in obesity. We have grants like I work with is reducing infant mortality, reducing childhood obesity, promoting cancer screenings, and working with reducing opioid addiction.
Gracious.
Mm-hmm. So we have a lot of programs going on in South Carolina.
Well, let's talk about some of the ones that you're involved in.
So one of the big ones that we're doing right now is the infant mortality, and beneficial for breastfeeding. So we know it really helps with babies and helping their lifespan. We are a donation site at our office. So women, if they produce excess breast milk, they can actually donate it to us, where we will send it to MUSC, they pasteurize it, and they'll send it to the NICUs in the state to feed preemie babies. And so it's really great. An ounce of breast milk can actually feed a premature baby for a day. And we've actually had about 1,000 ounces donated so far.
That's pretty exciting.
Mm-hmm, it really is.
But beside that, you're trying to offer support to local women who want to breastfeed and maybe don't have a mentor or a mother or a sister. How are y'all doing that?
So some of our counties, we actually have breastfeeding classes that we provide. I have opened the first ever in the state of South Carolina Baby Cafe, which is a support group for breastfeeding women. It can be if you are breastfeeding, if you want to breastfeed, if you have breastfed in the past and just want to support other women. So I'm a certified lactation counselor. They can come to us. We don't require appointments. We have no income restrictions. We're open once a week, and they can come in and just get support. And, you know, we have a really comfortable environment where they can lounge on pillows and breastfeed. We have light refreshments. It's just a really great atmosphere.
Do you get responses back that people feel like it's helped them to become
Yes. Especially if you're having issues with breastfeeding and, you know, you can't quite get into the doctor, or they're limited in what they can do with their health insurance, and they've got the support in the hospital system, but sometimes, you know, they might slip through the cracks afterwards and they don't really have that support. They can come to us and we can help them with it.
Well, we've got these little babies and then they're growing up, and then we've got, sadly, some obese children in South Carolina, and I think that's another issue that you're addressing.
It is. We don't know the rates just because it is so new with the childhood obesity. But right now what we're doing in our county is there are 5 districts in Anderson, and so we had a couple of them that applied for this grant, and it is through MUSC's Boeing Children's Center.
Oh.
They have been doing it for about 8 years, but they picked Anderson County, and we got District 4 in our county. And so the school system, what it is each school, there's 6 in that district. So each school has a wellness committee that they put together. They pick a leader, and they must meet 4 times a year on this wellness committee. And so really what they're trying to do is, what can we do in our school system to improve nutrition, physical activity? What can we do for our well-being? And so it's things like, you know, in nutrition, did they have tastings? If they held 4 tastings in a year, they can claim points for that.
To get kids to try, like, different foods, vegetables, fruits.
And, you know, unfortunately, you think about some of these kids, you know, their only meal they're getting is in school.
Uh-huh.
And so, you know, this is really helping them get things that they don't ever see before. And so physical activity, they'll have field days, things like that. Anything where they can really increase their physical activity, and they get a point system for it. And so at the end, if they hit a certain amount of points, they get a cash prize, and then the winning school wins an additional cash prize. And so they can put that money back into the school system and, you know, purchase equipment or something that they need.
I think that's pretty exciting. And you said this has been going on, although not in Anderson, but in other parts of the state. Does it have a good track record?
Yes, I believe it's been going on about 8 years, I think. But it's been going on for a while. And they do have, I don't have it with me, but they have a book where they print out and they show the outcomes for these schools. And, I mean, it's great. You know, you get so many comments and, you know, they do wonderful things. I remember one of the schools had a tasting and they did berries, and one of the little boys had never seen a blackberry before.
In South Carolina.
Yeah, never had a blackberry, never seen blackberry. I mean, these kids, and they love it, so they want to keep doing things like this.
And with the adult population, Hypertension leads to stroke and all this. Is it the silent killer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because a lot of people that get hypertension, there's not really a lot of symptoms. You don't know you have it until, well, you go to the doctor. But we also have a hypertension class that we can teach in our county. And it's really tailored for, you know, whoever wants it. It's 8-week course at about an hour for a class, but it goes over nutrition, physical activity, medication, stress management, and making long-term goals. And so it's really a great course that they just go through everything and how to manage their hypertension or how to prevent or reduce their risk of getting hypertension.
Y'all came to visit us at our studios in Sumter and talked mm-hmm. about reducing salt. And it was interesting to see there really is, it's a small amount of salt that you should have every day. Are people surprised sometimes when you start giving them the correct information? Do you think that just receiving the correct information can be beneficial?
Well, you know, with the salt that you mentioned, there's so many modifiable risk factors. So salt and, you know, lack of physical activity. When you're giving them tools that are, they're easy to change, then, you know, most people are really excited. But they're also, you know, when you open their eyes to showing them how much salt is in something, you know, looking at food labels, but also 2,400 milligrams is not a lot of salt. That's a teaspoon of salt. But that is what the average American. Now, doctors will sometimes put them on lower salt, 1,500 milligrams or less for salt intake. But, you know, just giving them the tools to help them really decrease how much they're getting in, they see such great outcomes from just a small move like that.
I think it's interesting that Extension started out trying to help people have enough food,
mm-hmm.
and of course they were working themselves, you know, all the time, so much exercise in the fields. But we see that Extension is changing as lifestyles change.
Mm-hmm. It has. It really has. We do still do the agriculture side, and we've actually had the FNET program, which is the Expanded Food and Nutrition Education Program. That's actually, we're about to celebrate the 50th year. So that is something Extension has done. So we've had the nutrition and we've had the, you know, the physical activity before, but this health, rural nutrition and health is just brand new for them. We've been doing it for about a year, and it's really starting to expand in most counties.
I think that it is important that as new problems and situations arise, that Clemson is expanding mm-hmm. its team of people to go out there and take the research-based information,
mm-hmm. yes.
as you've done, like with the Boeing program,
mm-hmm.
through the Medical University of Carolina, and tailor it to specific groups that we encounter in the state.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you see communities, you know, it's not just one individual. You see all sorts of different types of people, and so that's really what, you know, being a health extension agent is, working with different demographics. You know, we work with all sorts of races, ages, lifestyles, anything. And that's what part of a great program is you really tailor it for it to be focused for them.
I want to thank y'all for what you're doing and for sharing that information
with us. Thank you. I love doing it, so.